All right, folks, the deck is Troll Demon Hunter. This comes to us courtesy of Swaguar, so go check out his channel when you get a chance. But essentially, the goal of the deck is to ship a bunch of damage in the early game upstairs, get the opponent down to exactly 16, or at least close to it. Then we can play Proving Grounds with only two copies of Troll Cenarion in our deck, which will bash into each other and immediately deal 16 to the opponent's face. If you're watching this on YouTube, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You can catch me live at twitch.tv/Rockle. Don't draw either of them? Well, we've got glides, so. Feels like it's going to be difficult to pull off. We'll see. We just hold every card that isn't the troll, I think, right? Well, at least we can't draw one of the trolls. Double I-beam in the outcast slots. Seems good. I'm Skriss. Thank you for the 2 months. What if the demon companions mess up the honorable kills? I think it's unlikely that that happens for a variety of reasons. Because we just always roll Huffer, right? Wrong. Can kill a cannon, or just that if we want. It might actually be worth killing. Funkus. I think I can get a lot of repetitive damage from that if things work out, just because of the way that my hand is currently, because I've got like another I-beam next turn.
Someone's gotta lead the charge.
Who goes there? I already struck. Getting close. Need 8 more damage, and I've got 6 in hand. 7 with the hero power. That is not a card I was expecting to have to worry about here. Just maximize damage this turn, and we just play out our hand next turn, and hopefully have a proving ground soon. Okay, this oh no. Why are you running these cards in your deck?
need more gunpowder.
If it weren't for that stupid cargo guard, we'd have potential lethal with the Proving Grounds top deck. But because they're running bad cards, we get punished. Just play the game. Disgusting. Yeah, I lose. Did they build their Pirate Warrior to be more tempo based? No, they built their Pirate Warrior to win fewer games. The only explanation for those cards.
Illidan versus Rexxar.
Okay. It's just a face-off at this point.
This ends now.
Okay, we've got the Proving Grounds for maybe a turn six kill. Need to use my mana efficiently to deal as much damage as possible. That means probably working in hero powers and the weapon swings while I can. I'm honestly kind of scared of drawing cards, but it's still damage, so. Maybe Cargo was a sub for Patches? They had a Patches, didn't they? Wait, they didn't upgrade their hero power. I always just assume that it happens, but it didn't. That's bad. There goes the combo. Need to find a glide now and just rip it as soon as I draw it because I need to get the troll back into my deck. A little bit of redundancy there, but I'm just gonna go here, here, hero power next turn. And now I just need to top deck the Proving Ground. Seems as though every turn the opponent is like trying to figure out why they didn't add Baku to this deck. Why it's taking them so long. All right, Proving Grounds waiting room. Heal for more than this. So, this hero power. After Fel Barrage. Oh god. No, I need the Proving Grounds now, don't I? I don't think I can Fel Barrage. I wonder if they're running Feign Death.
Too much fury! Give them hell! Fear my glaive!
Okay. I have a fair number of lethal out here. That's one of them. No combo necessary that game.
Versus Taranda.
Your power is no substitute for true strength.
I will prove myself to you.
think I just keep this in case of aggro, which has been very common. Nope, not this time though.
Is someone injured?
Heal that next turn. That worked though. I think so. Cleric's kind of spooky. Gotta play this now.
I see. That one is not prepared. Our enemies will meet their ancestors.
That's very bad for me. For a variety of reasons. I need to find I need to find silence off of this. Bad. Another chance. It's probably GG. To be fair, they're gonna kill me before I hit the trolls anyway. You could get an honor kill on that because the trolls do have rush. So if I'm able to kill this. The one time I draw the Proving Grounds. I can't win from here.
I yield for now.
Ah, we're so close. If only it weren't a priest with taunts. If only it were a different deck and a different matchup and a different game entirely. That would have been perfect. Ah, yes. The mirror match.
The Legion's rage pales before mine. This ends now!
Yeah. Glide in the outcast slot. The outcast is less important than just, like, being able to glide away a whoopsie. Well. Hopefully I don't need to be gliding this game, I just need to maximize damage and not hit the troll.
One day I'll be a real knight.
Is there a way to draw Proving Grounds easily? I mean, if there were, it would be in the deck. Demon Hunter does not have, tutor effects. I need to force them to trade. No, Drekthar, please.
Our enemies will meet their ancestors.
One day I'll be a real knight.
Alright, I don't play the Chaos Strike next turn. But they also have two turns set up, so I'm just dead. I don't get there, do I? Unless I hit, some form of removal. Jeez. Needs to be an I-beam, most likely. I-beam or a really lucky Fel Barrage. Yeah, that's just GG. Close. Hey, welcome, Swag. I've yet to pull off the combo, so I have killed a quest line hunter just by hitting him in the face, but I have not comboed just yet.
Illidan versus Valera.
Watch your back.
This ends
a fair amount of damage, and we've got the proving ground, so. Try and avoid drawing the trolls and maximize our damage. Like, I don't know that I need to play this yet. I just start chipping damage with the glaive where I can.
None will survive.
Oh no. This is a problem. Problem that maybe Curtis could help with. I might just have to draw now.
I see.
GG.
Vengeance is mine.
Like, yeah, I can get a glide, but that's way too slow in this matchup, so. Just appreciate.
In the shadows.
Vengeance is mine.
Surely they will play an 8 health minion. Well, we do know there's a Baku in their deck. But, like, the problem is they kill me faster. Gotta go coin Curtis next turn. Yeah, that's never mind. We're dead. What a disgusting top deck. BRB.
Versus Malfurion.
You have much to answer for.
It isn't over between us, brother.
Gonna have to do a lot of damage this game to get them to 16, I think. Many people are roping me today. Every single game. I-beam is, or Blight is in the outcast slot. I-beam's probably not going to be a very good card in this matchup, but this is 2 mana deal 4, so that's not bad. I can just let her rip next turn. I could have Spectral Sighted there, but then I would lose the damage from the the Fel Barrage if they have a Oaken Summons here. A terrible draw for me. I just let go of the glide next turn, depending on what they play here. Nope. No need to yet. Just keep pushing damage. I was kind of wanting to glide this turn anyway. Six. A little bit short. Maybe I just kill the... They've already played a Ferocious Howl and a Branching Path. They're just going. Unlucky. You're welcome, Riffraff. The problem is they're going to break the weapon by the time that... Okay. Keep drawing. Nice. Ish. Oh. This is such a miserable matchup for me. At least they didn't get a taunt. Yeah, I don't think we're getting there. I think it's just too much armor. I think this is a borderline impossible matchup. Especially with that sequence of draws.
Makes right.
This ends now.
Yep, got a lot of early damage. Hopefully. Ruffle gives up too quickly, isn't he? I was in an impossible position. Why would I? What?
Happy Feast of Wintervale.
The opponent had 10 mana crystals. I had 0 mana crystals. It was uphill, I admit it. No, I lost the game.
Pirates away!
It's not sarcasm. In all honesty, the smart thing to do would be to concede here too, but like, Twitch chat's head would explode. Well, they've kind of fizzled out a little bit at least, so maybe there is still hope. Especially with that draw. Found all the I-beams.
I see.
Hold. Top deck troll, you get banned if that happens. So satisfying. Justice Crater, thank you for the 26 months. Whew. We did it, Reddit. Don't bring Reddit into this. They don't deserve to share our joy.
Illidan versus Taranda.
Your power is no substitute for true strength.
I will prove myself to you.
I think Glaive is an okay keep. Well, it's a little worse now. Okay. This is kind of why I wanted the Glaive. I want to be able to pick off Pirate, so okay. It's going to be a no from me, dog. I know I don't get the healing, but, like, I can't let them get any value off of that. I said I can't let them get any amount of healing off of that. Oh, it still does the plus one. Nice. JF, thank you for the prime. Okay, Curtis could help a little bit.
Come, pray with me.
I don't think I want to coin the Spectral Sight. I might need to coin the Curtis.
What is it? Come, pray with me.
I-beam?
I see.
That's bad. If they're not playing these, like, they must... Oh, God. Oh, okay. Never mind. I was concerned that they are, like, guaranteed to be, Mind Blast since they hadn't played them yet. And if they were Raise Deads, they absolutely would have. So they've got.
You win.
Okay. Ravu really gives up too easily, doesn't he? Like your chat voice, it varies from day to day. many priests are we going to queue into with this deck?
Wisdom shall bring victory.
This ends now.
Do I just hold the glide in the outcast slot in case that's a slow priest? No, that's just like... playing for a worst case scenario. Yeah. The real Chad play is to just draw the Proving Grounds. Easy. Another one? Yeah, people are starting to catch on that this deck is actually just very good.
What is it?
What is it?
Hey, I got you, friend.
Yeah. I don't think I have the luxury of trying to kill that anyway, so... enjoy your free cards, friend. Just need to get them to 16. By turn, I still need to draw I-Beam though, right? Because the repetitive damage does just kill me at a certain point, especially if they hit a Void Touched Attendant, which becomes more likely with the Pheasant on board. Hey, turn. Yeah. See card, play card. Like, I've almost got them in range already. What? Damage? Damage? No! I think I still just have to play the Proving Grounds to get the 8/8 out of my deck. So close.
Give me your best shot.
I think we're just dead though. You try to glide it back if possible. Yeah, but that's not going to happen this game. Because if I have to glide, then draw and play the Proving Grounds, I'm already dead. See, once again, this is a perfectly acceptable time to concede in a situation where I absolutely should concede.
You here for the tour?
Especially since they had lethal. I would have lost even if I didn't draw the troll, though. For the love of God, stop playing this deck? No. Unless you're talking to the opponents, then yeah, please stop playing that deck.
Illidan versus Gul'dan.
Your soul shall be mine. This ends now.
I mean, Warlock's just going to help me get there with their life tap, right? I might not even need to damage them. Would have been one off? Yeah, that's what I said. Can I get to Diamond 5 with this deck? Only if you have a really good bonus set of bonus stars. If you got the 11 star bonus, maybe, and even then, probably not. No. If you start from diamond foot one, sure. Yeah, that's true too. Oh, dear God. Oh, man. Oh, also, it's Reno. Wait. Oh, what a great, great draw. Okay. There's no reason not to attack there. If they tap, they're in lethal range. Alright, so I'm not playing the Spectral Sight. I'm not playing that. I think I just go flanking. And... Hero power phase. They're pretty likely to tap, right? Unless they just play the potion. But if they didn't get an AoE potion, it's fine. Wow. Quite literally the best potion they could have gotten. That's why I was a little bit hesitant to play... Okay, they're at 16. Hold. Don't breathe, chat. I'll know if you breathe.
Get your ugly mug out of my face.
Oh, we did it. Bonk! God, this... deck is so stressful. Gonna have to go to the emergency room after playing this deck.
Now you're sailing on my seas. This ends now.
A much better card. An honorable kill also trigger off killing the hero from the effect of the honorable kill. I guess, but like, I don't think there's ever a situation where that does anything relevant, right? Because the opponent's dead. One of those cards is helpful for me.
In the box? Pirate stuff.
Patches draw. through a pretty big patch as myself. Oof.
This is our chance.
Yar, it's a feed. It's mine!
Treasure? Loot? What more can I ask for?
Wait. Maybe they're just Bomb Warrior. Aha!
Glory! I'm here for the gold!
Someone's gotta leave. Yeah, it's just Bomb Warrior.
Is mine.
Give me your best shot.
Set sail. The Juggernaut is under my.
Bouts for lethal. How much is that? It's 11. That's got to be this one, right? Easy. Didn't even honorably kill. SMH my head. Good at Hearthstone? Good at calculating simple probability. Like, a substantial portion of my deck was lethal there. And also... Yeah, it's just the best play.
Illidan versus Nemzi.
I like Warlocks with this deck.
This ends now.
I feel like Fel Barrage is the worst card in this hand. Dominion down. Send it face. Oops.
No, don't. It's still good.
Oh, cute lock. Is not likely to get me the give me the time I need to win this. Then again, I've beat Shadow Priest a couple times, so anything's possible, I suppose. Well, they are doing damage to themselves with the race dead.
Keep up the aggression.
Dear God. Never mind. Not bad. Okay. I'm sorry I doubted you, Leok. Saturn, thank you for the prime.
You are not the boss of me.
Oh, never mind. I'm still dead. I'm still very, very dead. I'm just dead before turn 6, right? I don't think it's possible to be more dead than I currently am. Have I mentioned, chat, that I am in fact dead? Because I am very dead. Although, I mean, it's still 2 turn though, right? Like, I don't have. Maybe I can clear with this, and then they just tap into death range.
No, don't. It's still good.
Could you stop? Guess not. Confirm the opponent cannot stop. Pretty sure you win in fatigue, yeah. Getting there is the hard part. Alright, this hand is doo-doo. This hand has proving grounds. Cool. Just need to either survive until turn 6 or let the opponent tap themselves down to 16. Depends on what type of warlock we're up against. I feel like this deck has to just be nuts into Evenlock though, right? Mechathune to a lesser extent.
done.
Yep. Let's play that next turn. I don't think I need or want. I don't think I want to draw more cards right now. Ow.
Armor, armor. Lightly used armor.
You here for the tour?
Let's use my mana here. Sense. Not sure why they held back the tap though. We have lethal next turn, unless they heal. It's not necessarily easy to heal. No! Oh my god.
I see.
Okay. Okay. Unfortunate.
Let's wreak some havoc.
Think you should just rip it? I don't. I have too good of a play otherwise. And they have too much healing in their deck, and that gives them the information that they need to heal.
How much more are you willing to lose for vengeance?
Like, I don't even think it's close to a consideration here. Is Sphere good in this deck? No, it's terrible, because you would waste all of your charges attacking, and you're running three weapons.
Fire everything and everyone!
Haven't heard of me.
Oh no. So much healing. That person in chat is going to say, I told you so, and I'm going to get really frustrated with him for not understanding basic math. So they'll probably just be banned. Taunts are kind of a problem for me, right? I should probably try and find the glaive. Just so that I can get through, like, the Righteous Protectors. Okay. Well, it's only going to be a one-sided glide, but at least I have the glide.
There are no holidays for betrayers.
Els, thank you for the 2 months. Keep up the good work. Watch the stream on my lunch. Well, I hope you enjoy your break.
Fly, Polly.
It's kind of difficult. That actually doesn't matter, does it? I might coin a glide here anyway. Attack first. Annoying.
Job's done.
Let's actually play some cards that deal damage right now. What's that last secret? Avenge? Reckoning? There's a lot of things it could be. It could even be a competitive spirit, but not really a card that I can play around. I guess I can check for Avenge here.
My mana is too low.
Okay. Probably just play around competitive spirit here. Beautiful. Yeah, we dodged the troll, but we also lost the proving ground. But the proving ground isn't terribly relevant without the troll, or with the troll in hand, rather.
I see.
Ten. There's another do-over. Alright. Proving Grounds waiting room. It's fine. It's fine. I've got the glide still.
Vengeance is mine.
Alright, I've got a couple draws at it. One mana off.
This is our chance. Fly gum. It's mine. Fly off. Grows short.
Job done.
It's a 2 and 8. Oh, we did it! Oh my god. Whew. That glide pickup was just ridiculous. Outskilled? I drew so many trolls. What are you talking about? Clearly, the better deck builder won.
Embrace your destiny. This ends now.
Yeah, decent hand into Pirate Warrior. Need to rename in this deck Chump so it was his idea? Oh. Okay. That means I botched the intro, doesn't it? I don't actually know if I want to Spectral Sight next turn. At least in the description, yeah, I'll add a note. Thank you for letting me know, though. In turn. Oh, okay.
Pirates away!
In the box? Pirate stuff.
Kind of need to find a high beam, so I should probably draw, even though I'm hesitant to do so. Start here, though. That works. Yeah, opponent did draw patches. That's good news for me.
Glory! I'm here for the gold.
I think that single I-beam might give me the breathing room I need to just like shove everything face and not even worry about the Spectral Sight from here. Never mind.
I see. Vengeance is mine.
It's rough. Now, people enjoy playing the same meta deck over and over again, because they like winning. Like, again, I answer this every single time I stream. So, how do people enjoy asking the same question over and over again? Ralphel, why don't you like winning? I do like winning. Everybody likes winning. There are just things that I enjoy more than winning, and that's not necessarily the case for everyone else. Nor should you expect it to be just because it is for you. Like, I personally enjoy variety more than I like winning. And also, I'm, like, rewarded in terms of the content that I create for creating a variety of content instead of just playing the same deck repetitively. But, like, that just because that's the case for me doesn't mean I should expect everybody else to have the same motivation as me. Car is a 7-7, not with the captain, but I was just dead before the Rokara ever comes down. Hey, King Ogre. How are you doing today? Alright, if my draw is good, this feels like a good matchup for me, right? I feel once I get to Diamond 5, I can relax and play fun decks. Same, but that threshold is different for different people. Upper. Must be bugged. Just had a great ski day? Well, that sounds like fun. Hope you enjoyed yourself. Wait, they mulligan the quest. Did I get baited here? Just aggro, I guess, yeah. Seems weird. God, that was terrifying. I saw it come from the bottom of my deck and I thought it was the troll. For two. You just lose if you draw the Centurions? No, that's what Glide's for. But often, yes. Really kind of fizzled out on damage. After the first few turns. Oh my god, it's Exactis.
Vengeance is mine.
Give me your best shot.
I was looking at other lines, and then I double checked it. Whew. In my head, something was causing me to come up short. I guess I wasn't including the weapon damage, I think, so it's good that I set the weapon last turn. I thought you had equipped the weapon to set up lethal. I mean, I did, but then I forgot about it. Fury is not a keep. Fel Barrage is okay in this matchup. And Illidari Studies is potentially additional copies of Glide, or not Glide, I-Beam, which I might need. Just cash in on my damage now. Probably irresponsible, but
good hit.
When you prepare a video for YouTube, do you only include wins or admit if a deck is bad and show losses as well? Wins and losses aren't the thing that I am concerned about when I'm showcasing games. I try to showcase interesting games. Like, a lot of times losses are just me getting stomped by Pirate Warrior, and that's not entertaining to watch, so I just try and find the most entertaining games possible. Probably gonna coin the Curtis next turn.
In the box? Pirate stuff.
Pirates away!
Cannon shots. Oh wait, wow, well, they are way behind. I mean, if they attack into this one with the weapon, we have lethal, which is not an unreasonable play to expect here. I guess with the cannon shots, it's unlikely. Yeah.
We're gonna need more gunpowder.
Fine. Still winnable from here. Need them to play the Rokara this turn so that they're not hero powering. Good. Alright. Just don't draw the troll now. Easy game.
Fear my glaive.
Give me your best shot.
Oh, so satisfying. All right, let's go one more. Low-key farming Pyro Warriors. Do you have any other decks planned for today? Yes. The deck that I played in the first 2 hours of the stream. I see you later, Glitchy. Have a good weekend to you, too. This is not a bad hand for Pirate Warrior. Or against Pirate Warrior. You gonna play your quest or just hang out for a bit? Okay. Gonna be hard to get this active, but I think it's still worth taking because it's damage.
In the box? Pirate stuff.
Eventually. Now? Oh, right. It ended up being an order lol.
We're gonna need more gunpowder.
I can deal with that. May just end up needing to be a tempo glaivesmith. This deck can be very frustrating. Hey, Blade Runner.
Grab your cutlass. Let's
they still get the cannon shots, so I think it's just GG still. They're gonna take out the Gnarg. There's just no way out from here. I'm gonna get in seed and do another one since I've been going for a while, but I don't want to end on that one and I don't want to waste more of my time waiting for that opponent to realize that they've won. So in exchange for the early in seed, I will play another game. Seems fair. I was hoping to not have to end on a pirate warrior.
This ends now.
Probably just gonna rip this next turn since I have the glide as protection, but the rest of my hand is doo-doo, so I need to draw ASAP as possible. That means I need to swing. At least you can glide their Akara. Potentially, yeah. I don't know that I would count on doing that, though. Peace. Alright, get this for a captain or cannoneer. And like the Warblades actually does give me some staying power in order to like live after the Rokara swing.
Grab your cutlass. Let's buckle swash.
Hmm. Jeez. Gotta start picking across apart the board. Like, it's gonna take me a long time to get through this.
Glory. I'm here for
the Curtis can help. I'd probably just go flanking into Curtis, which may not give me the opportunity to deny their Rokara. Can't afford to wait a turn here. Just have to take the healing now.
We're gonna need more gunpowder.
In the box? Pirate stuff.
GG. This is what I was worried about with the gliding the Rokara. It's just not like a thing that is relevant. Honestly, the Rokara isn't, in an ideal circumstance, the Rokara isn't the threat. It's because they have to take a turn off, which gives me time to set up, which is what I need. So the bad thing that happens is the opponent kills you.
All hands on deck.
Pirates away!
Yeah. There's never a world where the Rokara mattered. Maybe I just needed to glide sooner. I think that, like, unironically, I think that them playing Rokara is to my benefit, so gliding Rokara is just a bad play. Because I don't have a way to clear the board, so it doesn't matter. Alright. Well, that was a fun deck. A stressful deck. I never want to play that deck again. I can assure you that. Thank you all for watching. I will be back after the weekend on Monday, so until then.